102 Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 534 in Pearl Jam with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102. Man, what a great night for Free Music Friday tonight at MGM. Sunny, a high of 78 today. Tonight, clear, low of 53. The rest of the weekend looks fantastic, too. Saturday, sunny at 85. Sunday looks pretty good, partly cloudy, and a high of 86. It's about 46 degrees right now in downtown Springfield. It is Friday, so that, I guess that means we're probably going to squeeze in an open line Friday later on today. Make sure you get your ideas percolating now, if you can. Also, check out the podcast. We posted after the show this morning. Brought to you by Marcotte Ford. They got your back for sales, service, parts, and rentals. Marcotte Ford in Holyoke. I guess there's a lot of stuff to talk about today. We'll get into it shortly. Bax and Nagle of Rock 102.
Rock 102's Classic Rock.
Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 5:52 and Pink Floyd with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
I would tell you what the forecast is, but, I'll just tell you real quick. Sunny and a high of 77 tomorrow, sunny and a high of 83. I'm really excited. I got my little soundboard back.
Well, let's see if it works. It might not work.
It might not work. Let's see. Joke of the day.
Yeah, that's not now.
You ready?
Yes.
All right. Oh, wait, no, it's not joke of the day. It's Hollywood Trash. What are we doing? All right, are you ready?
Okay, yes, yes.
All right.
Hey! Somehow you still care about what's happening in Hollywood. So, from Tinseltown, 3,000 miles away, it's Steve Nagle's Hollywood Trash.
All right, listen, before you get into it.
Yeah.
This is the best Hollywood Trash we've had in weeks.
Why is that?
Because none of this is my responsibility.
Oh, you don't have to push any of the buttons.
Yes.
Now it's all back on me. Lenny Kravitz hasn't been in a serious relationship for 9 years, and he's been celibate that entire time. He says it's a spiritual thing. This Wanda Sykes really can hold out. But his decision is also inspired by his dad cheating on his mother growing up. When he confronted his dad about it, his dad just said he'd be the same way when he was older. Lenny says, quote, "My dad became right after the marriage to Lisa Bonet. I became more like him. I was becoming a player. I didn't like it. I didn't want to be that guy. So I had to tackle that, and it took years by taking responsibility, discipline, and not letting my own desires take over." Hey, actually good for him, you know?
Yeah, I expected more from the Willises.
The what?
The Willises.
Oh, right. From
the Jeffersons.
From the Jeffersons, yeah.
Well, because Roxy Roker was his mom, and Tom Willis seemed like a decent guy.
In related news, Ice-T shared his thoughts about Lenny's celibacy. F that journey. That's weird to me. I love to F a lot. Well, that's Ice-T.
That's him.
He's not wrong.
No, it's hard to imagine that a guy who's that good looking is remaining celibate when there's probably so many options on the menu.
Probably. Remember the Dune 2 popcorn bucket that inadvertently came out to look like a sex toy?
I believe so.
It's Wolverine's head with the mouth wide open as if he's ready to make somebody incredibly happy. It doesn't
like he's just met Lenny Kravitz for the very first time.
Or Wanda Sykes, whichever one you want to do. It doesn't seem likely many guys could actually have fun with this bucket, though. The mouth is where you get the popcorn, so it's open really wide. But you can make it, if you can make it work, good for you, Hoss.
If you want to be Boss Hog in the movie theater.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it does look like, it's like this big, though. It's like the size of a grapefruit. You wouldn't be, that'd be like throwing a hot dog down a hallway.
And we all know what that means.
I think Kim Kardashian said it was yodeling into the canyon. 51-year-old Sofia Vergara wants to do every plastic surgery she can to keep from aging.
Don't do it.
You're a beautiful woman. What do you got to do that to yourself for?
You're going
to
ruin yourself.
She says if she had more downtime, she would have done stuff already. Quote,
"But because I'm in front of the camera, it's not like I can do something and then sit in my house recuperating for weeks."
Who is that?
That is Jerry Seinfeld.
I was hearing Charo in your voice.
Yeah. So in the meantime, she says she religiously uses SPF to prevent signs of aging. She also has been doing Botox for a long time in her neck and around her eyes, but not fillers. You know what people look the youngest? The ones who've never used makeup.
Yeah. Right. Because it doesn't damage their skin.
Yeah, there's nothing going on down there.
I'm telling you, I know some people that have done a couple of procedures and it makes them look goofy. It's not good.
Not good. But somebody told them it looks good.
Yeah, but they were wrong. They were lied to. Well, no one wants to tell someone who looks bad permanently, hey, you look bad permanently.
Minecraft recently celebrated its 15th birthday.
I'll be damned.
So it's about time it gets a TV show. Just look at Fallout and Halo and The Last of Us. The list of video game adaptations can go on. It's officially happening at Netflix, and it'll be animated. Not much is known about it yet, except it'll be an original story with new characters to show a new side of the Minecraft world. No word on when it'll come out.
This is what I predict. Kids will love it. Parents won't understand a bit of it. Just like the game.
I don't understand that game.
At all. I don't even understand why that's fun.
My youngest daughter made a cake for my oldest daughter for her birthday the other day. And put all this like Minecraft stuff on it. Like printed it out on the computer and made decorations and all this other stuff. It was actually a pretty well done cake. However, I didn't understand what any of it meant.
See? That's what I'm getting at. Adults don't understand it.
Parents just don't understand.
So true.
Will Smith and what's his
DJ
name?
DJ Jazzy Jeff
were right. It's not clear if anyone behind the Jason Momoa and Jack Black movie is involved, but it doesn't seem like it. The Minecraft movie will hit theaters next April. Minecraft is the best-selling video game of all time, with over 300 million copies sold.
Better than Pong?
That was better than that other one, Asteroids.
Asteroids. That was a good game.
That was a good game. A fan is suing Madonna because her concerts are too sexy. That's not the only reason, but that's one of the complaints. A guy named Jason Lippels filed a class action lawsuit in California claiming that Madonna and Live Nation tricked customers into buying expensive tickets by purposely and deceptively withholding information. For instance, they didn't tell concertgoers that her shows wouldn't start on time. They also didn't mention how hot and uncomfortable temperatures would be during the shows, or the fact that she would lip-sync much of them. Last but not least, Lebeau says he and other fans were not informed that they would be subjected to, quote, pornography without warning, including topless women simulating sex acts. Have you ever listened to Madonna, sir?
Have you ever followed the track of her career? From her sex book to Like a Virgin and then other things?
The suit seeks unspecified damages for breach of contract, negligent misrepresentation, emotional distress, unfair competition, and false advertising. If you buy a ticket to Foghat, you're going to hear Slow Ride.
Yeah.
If you buy a ticket to David Copperfield, you're going to see things disappear. And if you buy a ticket to a Madonna show, you're probably going to see some nipples at some point.
Either on stage or within the crowd.
Yeah, that's not an unreasonable prediction that's going to happen here.
I think this guy was looking for a lawsuit before he bought the tickets.
I think he's one of those guys that just wants he wants a piece of the pie.
I understand, but that's not right.
Kim Kardashian reunited with Kanye, her ex, to watch her kid's performance in The Lion King at the Hollywood Bowl.
She must have something to say.
Oh, my God, the last time I performed The Lion King was when Ray J shoved his Mufasa into my Hakuna Matata and gave me a Simba smear in that sex tape you can purchase on YouPorn for $39.95.
No worries.
No worries.
Caitlin?
I never got that done dirty with your mother, Chris Kim, but we once had a night of movies with Jurassic Pork. Then we went on to the car thriller, The Fast and the Bi-Curious.
What else did you see?
That Paul Walker was a snack. And then we finished off the night with a romantic comedy, My Best Friend's Wedding. Not wedding, wetting. There you go. And that is your Hollywood Trash from Rock 102. Ah!
Y'all do a Gary Room car wash, dog wash.
And now, Bax's View from the Couch, brought to you by Rocky's Ace Hardware, your grilling destination, Weber, Big Green Egg, Uni Pizza Ovens, and Traeger Wood-Fired Grills.
Hey, good morning, sports fans. How the heck are you? Well, folks, there you have it. It'll be the Boston Celtics facing the Dallas Mavericks in the NBA Finals, with Game 1 scheduled for next Thursday night in Boston. Last night, Luka Doncic dropped 36 points as Dallas advanced into the finals by pounding Minnesota in Game 5, 124-103. Now, I'm not a big fan of that guy, but that's mostly because he's very talented and scores a lot of points. But what I'd really like to see is the Celtics win this series because of Kyrie Irving, of whom I like even less, despite his three seasons in a Celtics uniform. Now, as of today, the Celtics are heavily favored to win the NBA Finals, and let me tell you why. Number one, Kristaps Porzingis will be back for the Celtics. Number two, you just have to look at the numbers. Since joining the league 44 years ago, the Dallas Mavericks have only managed to pick up one NBA championship, and that was in 2011 against the Miami Heat, exactly 13 years ago. 13 is an unlucky number. I'm also being told on ESPN.com that tickets for the Game 1 are going for as low as $666 apiece. And I don't think I need to tell you about the biblical implications associated with that particular price point. I should also point out that while Dallas only has one NBA championship, Boston has got 17 of them. 1957, 1959, 1960, 1961 through 66, 1968, 1974, 1976, 1981, 1984, 1986, and 2008. Combined, that equals a number that has no biblical implications whatsoever. And so, I believe they, based upon that shrewdly fabricated statistic, that the Celtics are practically a shoo-in to win championship number 18. Now, I know there are some of you people who are under the impression that I have the foresight and ability to jinx the Celtics into losing this championship series. Well, I don't. If they lose, it'll be because they didn't play well enough to win. Just like they did in 1985, 1987, 2010, and in 2022. And believe you me, I had nothing to do with the outcome of those disappointing outcomes. Having said that, I feel reasonably cocky that we'll be turning over emergency vehicles and setting trash receptacles on fire in no time at all with our 18th NBA championship. And frankly, I can't wait. But hey, enough of my yapping. Sports brought to you by Rockies Ace Hardware. When does grilling season begin? It never ends. You want to go to Rockies. They got all the grills, all the gear, and you get free grill delivery and assembly for grills over $400. Your grilling destination is Rockies Ace Hardware. I'm Bax. That's my view from the couch. Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock at 614, and Blue Oyster Cult, Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Mostly sunny today with a high of 77. Tomorrow, mostly sunny with a high of 84. It's 44 right now in downtown Springfield.
Good open line Friday coming up after 8 o'clock. Let's try to prepare ourselves. Let's try to think about what we want to talk about. Let's see if we can get through it without any profanity or hate speech.
I think that we could do that.
We'll see.
Hey, I'm reading this story here at a WCVB out of Boston. The motorcycle that was stolen Monday afternoon from a charity raffle at a New Hampshire tavern has been recovered in Massachusetts. The custom bike was supposed to be picked up by the winner of a raffle in which the proceeds of nearly $23,000 helped a struggling helped a family struggling with Alzheimer's. Surveillance video showed someone riding off the tavern's patio on a motorcycle. My bartender comes running up and says, "Someone just got on the bike and took off with it. Somebody just stole it," Hill Street Tavern owner Jake Magro said. "I thought they were joking with me at first." Police said the motorcycle fled south on Ocean Boulevard towards Massachusetts. According to a Wrentham police report, an officer saw a man, later identified as 36-year-old Brian Bennett of Amesbury, pushing a motorcycle along the breakdown lane of Washington Street just after midnight early Tuesday. The rider told officers his bike had died as he was walking to a nearby truck stop to get a jump start, which he was able to get from a vehicle there, according to report. Bennett told the officer he won the bike in a raffle in New Hampshire, adding that, "I won this!
This is my, it's a major reward!"
Adding that the bike was still registered in the previous owner's name and that the paperwork had not yet been processed. Yeah, who is this dealership that it belongs to? You know, because obviously, I'm guessing if it's a brand new bike, it's probably donated by, you know, like when Gary Rome donates a car to charity everybody puts in a raffle ticket for it, kind of thing.
Maybe. Well, let me ask you this though: if you want a bike at a raffle, and the bike dies in Wrentham, seems to me this guy did the potential winner a favor.
Yeah,
it's a dud of a bike.
You found out all the kinks that were in the bike.
I mean, you just got a you could have won a lemon.
When I walked to the back of the bike, I noticed it had a North Carolina motorcycle registration with the plate number Restless. Seeing me look at the plate, Brian attempted to shield it by walking in front of it. Brian's tone of voice appeared to be a little higher, and he spoke much quicker.
No, I don't know what I'm doing with the bike.
Bennett repeated the registration wasn't in his name, gave the officer his license information, and says, I'm not going to run on you. I don't worry, as he tried kick-starting the bike. The officer ran the plate, which indicated the bike was stolen. Bennett again told the officer he won the bike and rode away, ignoring the officer's commands to turn off the bike. Well, why wasn't he driving it to begin with?
It's a good question.
The bike broke down a short distance away on Washington Street, and he was arrested. Police found four knives in Bennett's possession, one of which was covered in blood. Police believe Bennett used the knife to dismember a deer carcass, parts of which were found in the motorcycle's saddlebags.
Wow.
Wrentham Police Chief Bill McGrath said some of the details were very troubling, including that Bennett said he had been eating the roadkill.
Are you okay, sir? I feel like $1 million. Get it?
A million bucks.
Yeah, because he was eating the deer carcass. He was cutting pieces and cooking it on the tailpipe. That's what he told us.
You're having a venison deer cookout.
Yeah, you have an old backstrap on the whole thing.
Bennett also told officers he had just stole a car from a rental place in Boston the other night, adding he was arrested by the Mass State Police after crashing the car and then was released on bail.
So this guy's got a history of problems here, right?
Yeah, he's got a little bit of a stealing issue.
Yeah, but then there's also the killing of roadkill. I don't know about you, but if I saw like a dead carcass on the side of the road, the last thing I'm doing is pulling out a fork.
Well, I mean...
Unless I'm going to push the animal off the side of the road with a fork.
Listen, it's like that Snickers commercial. Not feeling yourself lately, you know, and then you bite into a deer carcass and all of a sudden you're back to normal. Hampton, New Hampshire police said a warrant was out on Bennett, charging him with theft by unauthorized taking. Bennett was charged with receiving a stolen motor vehicle, subsequent offense, and failing to stop for a police officer. He was also charged with felony nighttime breaking and entering and malicious destruction of property. With the break-in at about 11:40 p.m. at Helping Hands of America.
So wait, he was charged with theft by unauthorized taking?
Yeah.
Isn't that the very definition of theft?
Well, I guess.
I mean,
so.
No one commits theft with an express written consent from Major League Baseball. I mean, that just doesn't happen.
Bennett is undergoing a mental health evaluation. Well, you don't say.
I don't know, but what's that based on?
Police are still trying to reunite the motorcycle with its rightful owner. How do they not know who it is? Or how would it not be reunited with them fairly quickly?
Well, is it evidence?
Oh, it could be.
Yeah, then if that's the case, then they stick with it for a while.
You know, this is exactly why I don't ride motorcycles.
It's also the reason why I don't participate in raffles in a bar.
Yeah, that's probably a better option.
Yeah,
but it was a fundraiser thing. They were trying to raise money for a family that needed the money.
Did they still get the money?
Well, I'm sure they do.
Well, then everything is all right as rain then.
Is it though? Is it right as rain? What about that poor deer in the family?
Well, listen,
was supposed to graduate tomorrow.
He was supposed to start a new job the following day.
Yeah, he was. He had done the ROTC program at his high school.
Next thing you know, you got deer chops on the on the exhaust pipe.
Yeah, and now his parents are mourning his death. This guy who stole a motorcycle from a raffle. These people in New Hampshire are nuts.
More than you might know. It's 6:21 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Home improvements.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 6:27, and the Rolling Stones of Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Don Marr has the full forecast.
Oh, Don's filling in today, huh?
Yes.
All right.
His very low voice that I had to crank up to like 100.
He has to whisper. Apparently, that's just the way it goes over there.
A careless whisper.
I don't know if it's careless. I just think it's, he's a very low talker.
I think it's careless.
Okay. Be that as it may.
Hey, do you want to laugh?
I do.
All right.
It's Bax and Nagle's joke of the day.
I'm funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown, I amuse you.
On Rock 102.
I make you laugh.
Springfield's classic rock.
So a guy walks into a psychologist's office, and he's only wearing saran wrap pants.
Saran wrap pants?
And the doctor looks at him and goes, well, I can clearly see your nuts. Why is he? Because he can see right through the saran wrap. And he's also kind of crazy. Perhaps he's taking motorcycles from New Hampshire.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Now, visit HarmonyHouseWMA.org to purchase tickets. That's HarmonyHouseWMA.org. Be a part of the mission at Harmony House.
6:31 with Bax and Nagle and Rock 102. It's time for news brought to you by Noonan Energy, reliable service for heating, cooling, electrical, and plumbing at Noonan.com. Here's your local radio icon, Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax. Donald Trump became the first former president to be convicted of felony crimes Thursday as a New York jury found him guilty of falsifying business records in a scheme to illegally influence the 2016 election through hush money payments to a porn star who said the two had sex. The verdict is a stunning legal reckoning for Trump and exposes him to potential prison time in the city where his manipulations of the tabloid press helped him catapult from a real estate tycoon to reality television star and ultimately president. As he seeks a return to the White House in this year's election, the judgment presents voters with yet another test of their willingness to accept Trump's boundary-breaking behavior. Trump addressed the crowd assembled outside the courthouse after the verdict was announced, blasting the decision in the words that he has repeated throughout the trial, calling it rigged and accusing Judge Juan Merchan of being conflicted.
You know, ultimately speaking, felony convictions wouldn't prevent him from running. It wouldn't prevent him from serving. And it's not entirely clear whether he'll serve a day in jail.
Well, people like that don't go to jail.
See, that's kind of what I'm thinking. If you can afford good enough attorneys.
Let me tell you, rich people only go to jail if they steal from other rich people. Think about that. Think about that Bitcoin, or not the Bitcoin guy, whatever that guy. Remember the guy that just went to jail?
Yeah.
Because he screwed all those people out of money?
Yes.
He screwed a bunch of rich people out of money. Now he's going to jail.
That's why Bernie Madoff.
Yeah.
Is in jail because of the scale of what he was stealing.
Right.
It's not to say that Donald Trump couldn't use a few years in prison. That might toughen him up a little bit. But I don't know if he's going to see anything. I just think he's just gonna
he's not
skate.
Going
to be on probation, and in some states he won't be able to vote.
I don't understand the whole. I don't even want to get into it because I kind of don't really care.
Right.
But it just seems like these are all just theatrics to get people angry with each other.
Well, here's the thing. Even after yesterday, he and Joe Biden are still tied. And yeah. So I don't know what you got to do to prove one way or another, but it doesn't appear to be changing anyone's voting pattern. Like, if you were going to vote for him, you're probably still going to vote for him. And if you weren't, you're probably not.
It's the same for both parties. I think if you were dead set on one, nothing's really going to change your mind about that.
I also think you have to consider, do any of us really truly believe that any politician at that level is not a lying dirtbag somewhere down the road? Like, they've all kind of done something that probably they shouldn't have done?
Yeah.
Because I'd got to be honest, I don't trust any of them.
Yet except we interview them every year, when we get our nice little donations from them for the Mayflower Marathon.
Right, of course. Yeah. Well, yeah, but that's for the greater good. The only politician that I trust is Mayor Domdom, because to not trust him runs the risk of him ripping my spine out through my nose. Because
he's got that kind of physical power.
Yes,
on you.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it.
The victim in a deadly stabbing on Saturday in West Springfield has been identified. On Saturday around 10:02 p.m., officers were called to the area of Amistown Road and Kings Highway for a report of a stabbing in the area. Police found a victim of the incident and began first aid and CPR. He was taken to Bay State Medical Center but later died from his injuries. The Hampden County DA's office identified the victim as 50-year-old Joseph Seymour of West Springfield. West Springfield police, along with the Hampden County DA's office, are investigating the incident. A motorcyclist is dead after a crash on Main Street and Union Street in Springfield Wednesday night. According to Ryan Walsh, officers were called to a crash involving a motorcycle and a car around 8 p.m. at the intersection. The motorcyclist, identified as an adult man, died from his injuries in the crash. Walsh said the motorcyclist allegedly ran through a red light and hit the car who had the right of way. The driver of the car stayed at the crash. Springfield police are still investigating the crash at this time. Over in Springfield, the search for the next superintendent came to an end Thursday night.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. After weeks of controversy and a thorough interviewing process, Dr. Sonia Denal was selected over the other two candidates. The three were asked how they would create a more diverse teaching staff, implement innovative learning methods, and what their future plans include. Dr. Denal was the previous chief of family and community engagement for the Springfield Public Schools. She said that she's ready to make a difference within the school district. I'm determined to continue to use my career to level the playing field, champion equity, mitigate barriers to empower our students to achieve their greatest goals and the biggest dreams. Dr. Denal will lead the district of nearly 24,000 students in more than 60 schools starting next year.
All right. Very good. Congratulations.
Yeah, well, I guess, you hire from within.
Yeah.
That's probably a better choice than importing or somebody from outside.
Maybe. I mean, it's good to see someone from within the system get elevated, but I think when you got a job this big, doing a national search isn't the worst thing out there. I mean, it doesn't exclude local people, but casting a wide net probably was for the best.
Get it out there. Let's see who we can gather up in this.
Absolutely.
Mess. The victim of a deadly shooting last week in Springfield has been identified. At 10 p.m. on Tuesday, May 21st, officers were sent to Fort Pleasant Avenue for a shot spotter activation. When officers arrived, they found a man that was shot. He was then taken to Bay State Medical Center, but later died from his injuries. The Hamden DA's office identified the victim as 30-year-old Aaron Cabrera of Ludlow. The homicide unit, along with the DA unit, murder unit, are investigating the shooting. If you have any information on the incident, you're asked to call the police or text the tip anonymously. A basement fire on Carver Street in Springfield Thursday has displaced 8 residents and resulted in the rescue of 8 dogs. Ooh, one dog for every resident.
That's a lot of dogs.
According to the Springfield Fire, crews were called to 38 Carver Street early Thursday evening for a reported basement fire. Firefighters were able to quickly contain the fire to the basement and successfully extinguish it without any reported injuries to the residents. The 8 individuals affected by the fire are receiving assistance from the Red Cross. Firefighters rescued 8 dogs from the basement. 4 of the dogs required resuscitation using specialized canine resuscitation masks and oxygen, a procedure that successfully revived the animals. How come nobody did that to that poor raccoon that was run over?
I don't know of anyone that's ever done mouth to mouth resuscitation with a raccoon.
I don't know. I had a friend of mine who was dating this crazy girl who said she resuscitated a raccoon that was dying in the middle of the street. It was a completely fabricated story.
Right.
But with her medical knowledge, she was able to resuscitate the raccoon successfully. But that's why she was late. But this was
her excuse?
That was her excuse, that she had to pull. She was like 2 hours late getting to where he was, and he wanted to know why she was late. And she said that she had come upon a sick raccoon in the middle of the road and tried to resuscitate it.
Right.
And then later turns out she was just seeing some other dude.
See, I'd be more likely to believe an alien abduction than that story.
Yeah, well, I mean.
And even that I might not believe.
It's funny what lengths people will go to hide whatever they're doing maliciously. Like she was seeing somebody else on the side.
Right.
And then trying to balance that story out by coming up with something even more ridiculous. I resuscitated a raccoon. Yeah.
You know, that had to be a story she had in her head on the drive out.
Yeah.
How am I going to explain this away?
Yeah, I don't.
Oh, there's a dead raccoon on the side of the road. I'll use that as my excuse.
Yeah,
good choice.
Oh, well, with all my medical, I think she was like a phlebotomist or something. With her medical expertise,
sure.
She was able to revive that raccoon.
Right.
from all that work in the ER that she did over the years.
God, she was such a hero for a half minute.
Hey, you know what? Not all heroes wear capes, Bax.
So true.
Some people have, some heroes are just mentally ill and like to make up stories. That's how it works. Holyoke Public Schools will change its dismissal schedule district-wide in the fall, dismissing students a little earlier, one day per week. Thank God our union fight is over.
We've been fighting for this for years. How early are they being released? Much earlier?
Early start schools will release at 1:30 p.m. on Wednesdays rather than 2:30 p.m. That includes the Holyoke STEM, McMahon, Metcalf Middle, Holyoke High North, and Holyoke High Dean. The Transition Academy will run until 2:20 p.m.
Does that mean they're getting there earlier?
It's regular time. It's one day a week that they're getting out early. Late start schools. Oh, so like the late start schools, which include the Lawrence, Morgan, Sullivan, and Middle, will release at 2:30 p.m. every Wednesday. The Opportunity Academy will always release at 3 p.m. The Opportunity Academy will not get the opportunity to be released early.
Well, that's ironic, isn't it?
It's very ironic. In a statement issued alongside the announcement, Superintendent Anthony Soto said the dismissals are in pursuit of a better support for teacher development and to improve teacher retention, which has proven positive of effect on student achievement. Reaction to the plan from parents doing the morning drop-off at Lawrence Elementary was mixed. As a parent, that's going to be a difficult for scheduling, but the kids like it. They're happy about it, so I'm willing to try it out and see. And then another person said, for me, it's a good thing because kids get more time at home. The teacher gets more relief time, and they get more time to catch up on things for the week. For the parents that do have a scheduling conflict, picking up their kids an hour early, the district said they are working with local child care providers to provide extra spots for elementary and middle school students on Wednesdays.
You know, my father used to work in a school system for years and years and years.
Yeah.
And he always said, and I totally believe this, that the best part of any teacher's day is the time of the day when they are no longer at school.
Yeah.
That's the best part of the day. Is the time they get to leave.
Of course it is.
I think that's probably true of a lot of professions. But the best part of the day is the day you walk out the door.
You mean for the teachers?
For a lot of professions. Yeah. I mean, my favorite time of the day is when I get out of here.
I've been watching a lot of these TikTok videos and the way these kids treat teachers.
Yes.
First of all, if I had ever done anything half as disrespectful as some of these little dirtbags do,
mm-hmm.
in my day, I would have not have only received the punishment at school, but also some probably corporal punishment at home.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I just I give teachers a lot of credit because they have to put up with this kind of nonsense with these kids just, you know, tell them to go F themselves
and not
paying attention and, you know, doing all this stuff. It's kind of.
I stumbled across one TikTok. It's some woman. She's a teacher, and she's a very attractive woman.
Yeah,
but she's been reading the actual comments that she's gotten in class from students.
Yeah,
calling her fat, calling her ugly, calling her stupid. It's relentless, and you can just see there's like a dead look in this poor woman's eyes. Like after like, you know, five or six of these comments, she's like. All of a sudden, there's like nothing left inside of her. Yeah. They've totally ruined her for life.
I read some other thing where this guy, he had, I think it was on a Reddit. He was a teacher, and he's been doing it for 20 years. But at the end of every year, he gives them the opportunity to write anonymous comments about. Is that what this was too? Somewhere along the lines of that.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. So he said, I've been doing it every year, but this is the first year these kids were like, you have an incredible amount of patience. And he's like, it's not patience. It's just waiting for people to stop talking. Because he said he won't continue if people are talking. And eventually, they'll pay attention if you just don't do anything.
Maybe. But there's also some kids that would mow you down nothing.
But I think with this guy's approach is like, okay. He goes, I'm getting paid either way. To sit here kind of thing. He likes teaching. He wants to teach. But if nobody's going to pay attention, he's just not going to do the job. And it doesn't matter to him either way because he still gets the paycheck at the end of the week. And he's been doing it for 20 years, so it's not like he's going to get fired.
You know, anyone who says that, you know, the teacher shouldn't get paid what they get paid because they get 10 weeks off or, you know, 8 weeks off in the summertime.
That's not enough.
Absolutely no idea what it takes to teach your rotten little kids.
Listen, it's hard enough balancing two kids on my own. I can't imagine having a classroom full of 27 of them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Imagine like, being responsible for a whole bunch of them as opposed to just the two you have on your own.
Yeah.
No, thank you.
Yeah. Anyway, well, enough of our soapboxing on teaching. Your Pioneer Valley forecast today, mostly sunny, nice day, high of 77. Tomorrow, more of the same with a high of 84. It's 45 right now in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on Rock 102. Aw, yeah.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 6:54 and Collective Soul with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Going to be sunny with a high of 77 today. Tomorrow, sunny with a high of 84. It's 45 right now in downtown Springfield.
Hey, next week on Bax's Musical Podcast, I'm really excited about this one. John Rubley, former Atlantic Records Vice President of A&R, is going to be joining me. He and I went to college together, but his career is a fascinating one. He not only was the Vice President of Atlantic Records, he also was the guy responsible for booking the second stage of Lollapalooza. There's a brand new documentary series on Paramount Plus called Lolla, the History or the Story of Lollapalooza. It's a great documentary, and I had a chance to talk to him earlier this week. That'll get posted on Monday. It's on Apple Podcasts, SoundCloud, Spotify, and on rock102.com. It's all brought to you by Metro Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Chicopee.
There you go.
There you have it.
Do we have the sound thing on this thing?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, well, someone took a survey.
Oh, yeah?
Right. Why does this not work?
All right, then I'll do it.
All right. Survey set. Thank you very much. Someone took a survey and asked if women should be allowed to go topless at places like water parks and beaches. You know, we've heard this argument. Remember the lady up at Hampton Beach was trying to do that for years?
Oh, yeah.
The argument for it is, if men can, why can't women? How many times have you gone topless at a beach?
What's your favorite topless story?
The argument against it is not appropriate, especially with kids around. Around 3,000 people voted, and most said yes, women should be allowed to bear it all if they want to. And 75% think it should be an option for both men and women. I'm against this, not because of exposure to kids. I mean, they're just nipples. Everybody has one.
I've got them. You've got them.
Brown protuberances.
Right.
But have you ever seen the Neanderthals at a water park? Would you want to see many of them naked?
I would have to say no. But you know what? I am not the kind of person that is going to stand in the way of someone wanting to just, you know, be footloose and fancy free. I mean, ladies, if I would not stand in your way. If you want to be topless, I would allow you. I would not protest.
But I think, I guess it depends on what you look like.
Well, Steve,
I don't take my shirt off anywhere.
Oh, either do I.
Because I don't want to subject anybody to that mess.
Yeah, see, I'm kind of feeling the same way. I don't have that same kind of Lizzo-style body positivity.
Right. But I would expect other people should not as well.
Yeah. Well, you know, the thing is, though, I've been on beaches that were topless.
Yeah.
You know, like in other foreign countries. And you know what? It's silly. It's so stupid that we've got such a hang-up on women, you know, baring their chests. It should not be a big whoop. But we Americans, for whatever reason, are sexually repressed, and you know, for whatever reason, we feel like we're holding women down when they just need they should have every right to be as topless as we do.
You're missing the point. It's not about your rights. It's about what's right. Like you should, if you're this knuckle dragon Neanderthal going into the water park to get your kids all bathed up for the day. I don't think you should be taking your top off.
Steve, I am not as shallow as that, where I believe that even Quasimodo's sister could enjoy a nice day at the beach.
Right.
If she really wanted to, she could. And I would not protest.
I would not protest either.
Yeah. But what I would do is I put my sunglasses on and pretend I'm not looking.
I'm just trying to play devil's advocate here.
Understood.
Yeah.
Yeah. I get it. I just, you know, I'm not a judgmental type.
what's your topless take? 413-293-1021 on the Route 10 Tire Listener Line. The phony phone crank call coming up after 7.
It's 6:58 of Rock 102.
Summer is almost...
Hey, good morning, sports fans. How the heck are you? Folks, I'm sure most of you are very well aware that today is the third round of the French Open at Roland Garros in Paris, France. I'm sure that's all I've been thinking about this week. I don't care how many former elected world leaders are getting slapped with 34 felony convictions this week. My only concern is how this is affecting major international tennis tournaments. And frankly, no matter where you fall on the political spectrum, the French Open has got its own problems to deal with. Yesterday it was announced at Roland Garros that alcohol will no longer be served at the French Open after one drunken fan was accused of creating a ruckus and disrupting a match between David Goffin of Belgium and Giovanni Pesti-Pericard from France. According to French Open officials, that match was disrupted when a drunken spectator took an unusually large wad of chewing gum out of his mouth and hurled it towards David Goffin. There have been other incidents as well, and as a result, tournament officials have imposed a ban on any alcoholic beverage from being brought into the stands. Oh, you can drink yourself silly in the concourse, but don't you dare think about bringing that drink with you to your seat. Folks, this is the French Open we're talking about here. The average annual consumption of wine in the country of France is approximately 47 liters per person. Factor in the metric conversion, and that equals approximately per capita consumption of 196.6 cups of their crummy wine per person, which works out to 12.4 gallons for every one of those arrogant Frenchmen. Banning alcohol at the French Open would be like banning the sale of Fenway Franks during a Red Sox game. Let's not punish everybody because of the gum-chewing habits of one single individual. Let's just ban the guy who's chewing the gum. You know, the guy that didn't think had the sense enough to bring gum enough for everybody. But hey, enough of my yapping. Sports brought to you by Rocky's Ace Hardware. Man, weeds are ugly, and they're troublesome. Scott's Naturescape Mulch. That's the good-looking stuff. It's well-behaved, and it's on sale at Rocky's. Get Classic Black, Sierra Red, or Deep Forest Brown. 2 cubic foot bags. 3 for $10 at your neighborhood Rocky's Ace Hardware. I'm back. That's my view from the couch. Rock 102 Springfield's Clash of Classic Rock at 7:13 in Aerosmith. With Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
It's going to be a nice day today. Sunny and a high of 77. Tomorrow, sunny and a high of 84. It's 45 right now in downtown Springfield.
Got Open Line Friday coming up next hour, so make sure you are preparing yourself for that so we can get through that virtually unscathed. You eat a good deal of meat, right?
I like meat.
Yeah, I like meat. I like meat a lot.
And this just falls in line with our Food Fridays that we talk. You know, we talk a lot of food here around the office.
Well, let me put the brakes on that because this story, I think, will kind of pull that desire out of you. Lab-grown meat is not currently available in the United States grocery stores or restaurants. And if some lawmakers have their way, it never will be. Early this month, both Florida and Alabama banned the sale of cultivated meat and seafood, which is grown from animal cells. In Iowa, the governor signed a bill prohibiting schools from buying lab-grown meat, and federal lawmakers are also looking to restrict it as well. It's unclear how far these efforts will go. Some cultivated meat companies say they're considering legal action in some states, like Tennessee, shelving proposed bans after lawmakers argued that it would restrict consumers' choices. Still, a deflating end to a year that started with great optimism for the cultivated meat industry. Apparently, two California startups, Good Meat and Upside Foods, have been selling cultivated chicken. Two high-end U.S. restaurants briefly added the products to their menu. Some cultivated meat companies began expanding production. One of the Good Meat's products went on sale at a grocery store in Singapore. And I don't know how good it is, but, you know, something just doesn't sound healthy about cultivated lab-grown meat.
What are you talking about? We have you can grow vegetables in a hydroponic chamber.
Yeah, that's fine, but that's not a laboratory. That you're basically creating an environment, a habitat for plants to grow.
Yeah,
A petri dish. With cells and some sort of chemical going in there to expand the growth of these cells? I don't know. Want that.
If you were allowed to do this at home, like with a mad scientist kid, who wouldn't want to grow a cow in their living room?
Well, what do you do with a cow in your living room?
You cut it up and you eat it.
Yeah, but if a cow is growing up in your living room, yeah. Don't you think you probably have some sort of emotional attachment to the domesticated cow?
No, you don't name it. If you name it, then it becomes personal. If you just say, this is the living room cow, this isn't...
Yeah, but Steve, but if I've got the cow in my house and I'm providing the cow with like cow toys or, you know, like a cow bed to sleep on, or,
yeah.
You know, he wants to crawl in bed with me, the cow, you know, it's hard not to get personal, hard not to build a bond with the animal, even if you don't even name him. You just name him, hey, it's the cow.
The thing I don't get is, are we so short on food that we have to resort to this? Or is this just, hey, let's make some money off this weird idea that my roommate came up with in college.
Well, I'm sure there will be some people will say, well, you know, it's cruelty free.
Yeah.
You know, no actual cows, chickens, or pigs had to die in order to
create this meat. You're not cloning an animal. You know, I'm joking about the cow in the living room thing, but you're not actually cloning a real live animal. You're only cloning like the muscle mass and the meat portion of the thing.
Allegedly so. So if you wanted to like
grow your own T-bone.
Right, but probably without the bone. It'd probably be just the meat.
Okay.
You know? I don't even know how good that would be.
Well, we gotta find out.
Not really all that interested in trying it. You know, I tried the fake plant-based stuff.
Beyond meat.
I don't care what anybody says. It is no replacement for the actual succulent goodness of dead animal flesh.
It isn't, but I also, when Burger King came out with those Whoppers, with the Beyond Whoppers,
yeah,
you couldn't really tell the difference. There was a little bit of a taste difference in there.
Well, it's the flame broiling.
Yeah, I don't think that really has anything to do with...
You don't think
so? ...with
the
taste. But yeah, it wasn't bad. But I don't know. I'm a little on the fence about something that was, you know, supposed to be naturally bred in the wild,
right,
if you will. Not wild, but even if you're on a farm.
Well, I mean, you've read these stories about these plant-based Beyond Burgers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
They're not healthy. They're not. They may be plant-based, but ultimately speaking, they've figured out that these things are still made with chemicals, and they're still made with additives and preservatives, so they don't rot.
What kind of meat, how healthy is this? Has anybody tested it yet?
It can't be any, well, I don't know how healthy it is. I know that there's nothing wrong with, you know, red meat as it is. That's perfectly healthy stuff. I could eat like a whole, you know, pork shoulder and not feel any, you know, effect on my health whatsoever. Especially all that delicious melting fat, you know, that's delicious. That's healthy.
Yeah, but I'm wondering if you would even know the difference.
Psychologically, I would know the difference.
Yeah.
If I had the choice between, I would be very surprised if you put like a side-by-side comparison of like a ribeye that's been made in a lab and a ribeye that's been butchered from the farm.
Yeah.
I'd be very surprised if the lab-grown meat was better. Because it's not real. It's just it's fabricated. There had to be some sort of chemical added to these cells to turn this into actual meat.
Yeah, we have a listener texting in on the Route 10 Tire listener line at 413-293-1021. And she points out, we already eat plastic Twinkies and things like that. So is it just the idea that something is being grown in a lab that grosses you out? Or is it...
Well, because
I don't know if you'd know the difference, and I don't know if I'd know the difference either.
Well, quite honestly, I can't really recall the last time I ate a Twinkie or bought a Twinkie. Like, I got a notion, like, I sure could use some fabricated sponge cake filled with cream that's not anything, that's not really dairy.
Yeah.
I haven't had a real craving for any of that.
Are you telling me there's no cream in a Twinkie cream?
It's not actual cream.
What is it?
Some sort of petroleum-based sludge that was made in a laboratory.
I kind of like that.
Yeah, no, I understand it's delicious, and you know, Twinkies have been fulfilling people's dietary needs for years. But yeah, you know, given a choice between like pork chop and a Twinkie, I don't think a Twinkie stands a chance.
Listen, if anybody's ever eaten an Applebee's, that's what I would imagine lab-grown meat tasting like.
Yeah. Maybe. I don't know.
Like marinated.
Well, remember
for preservation.
Remember the pink slime scandal from a few years ago,
which wasn't even real.
Right, but when people realized that, were being told that that some of these fast food burger joints were adding pink slime to the meat to extend the use of the meat and drive the cost down, everyone was all up in arms about the idea that they were eating some sort of
weird
sort of chemically based additive to the meat.
But it wasn't true.
Allegedly not true, but.
Yeah.
At some point, this stuff may be readily available to drive the cost down, and I don't like it.
How about making some lab-grown stand-up comedians? They can start and set them up at the Shortstop Bar and Grill every Thursday night for $20, dinner and a show. Hey, you know what? Somebody gets it in there.
Somebody's understanding the deal here.
Yeah, yeah. But we only serve fresh meat.
It's interesting that this story is coming out. I don't know if you saw this from like a week ago. I don't even know how we missed the story. Kobayashi has retired. Did you know that?
No, I had no idea.
Yeah, 6-time Nathan Hot Dog Eating Champion says that he feels broken inside and doesn't feel like he's feeling like this may be affecting his health.
Yes.
All this competitive eating.
I'm sure. Oh, really?
Yeah.
How would somebody not think that would eventually take a toll on their body by doing that to themselves?
I don't know. I mean, he began his competitive eating career knocking down 12 bowls of ramen noodles in less than an hour.
That's a lot of, you got to have a lot of, like, I don't know, desire to do that, to be the winner of that.
It takes a lot of a lot of self-motivation.
Well, I mean, if he ate lab-grown hot dogs,
would you wonder.
Would he still be a champion?
These are tough questions. And Kobayashi will not be coming back to competitive eating, so we'll never be able to answer that.
I think I would enjoy some lab grown meat.
No, yeah. I think I would be a lab grown meat snob.
Listen, I wonder how long it takes to grow. Hey, you want to come over for a barbecue? You got to give me 6 weeks. I'll have a lamb shank ready for you the 20th.
Will I still develop?
Yeah.
The abdominal intestinal blockage like it would with regular meat?
Yeah, I don't know. These are all the questions. This is what the future is about, Bax. It's learning to enjoy new things.
It's 7:23 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Call or text us any.
Come network with Mayberry Associates and friends and support Totally Adaptive's fitness programs, where your way is the right way. For more information, visit Mayberry.com. That's MAYBURY.com. I hope to see you on June 18th. Thank you.
7:26, Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Don Marr has all the full forecast for you.
Now, I'll tell you this. The forecast for the rest of the weekend is looking pretty damn good. So if you're a golfer, this is the time to get onto Rock102.com and get yourself the Rock 102 Golf Club. It's brought to you by Swing Oil Beer. You get deeply discounted rounds of golf at some of the area's great courses. You got two options to choose from. We got the North card, which includes Northampton, the Links at Worthington, Blandford, and Brattleboro. The South card offers Keeney Park, the Ledges, Wyckoff, Goodwin Park, and Agawam. You can buy one, you can buy both, you can buy a dozen of them if you really wanted to. You're paying less than $20 a round. It's a hell of a deal for any golfer. It's the Rock 102 Golf Club, brought to you by Swing Oil Beer, available for a limited time. So get yours today at rock102.com.
There you go. Yeah, it's going to be a really nice weekend.
Hey, next week, we'll not only have Scott Cowan, but we will have John Lodge from the Moody Blues.
Oh, sweet.
Bona fide rock and roll Hall of Famer who has sold more than 60 million albums during the course of his very lucrative career.
Wow.
Yeah, I know, huh?
That's looking pretty good.
Yeah, he's coming to Boston, and he's also coming to Hartford, too. So that's, we'll give you all the details about that.
And you're off next week, right?
Thursday and Friday.
Yeah. Ooh, it's like a comfort cruise for me.
Yeah, it'd be real
coming
simple.
Coming in here pushing buttons and pretending I care.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I know.
Ah.
I'll be representing the radio station, doing some professional things.
You know what? Of all the years you've been representing the radio station down there, I've never heard any feedback from that at all.
Because they don't tell you. They tell me.
What do you mean they tell you?
Once I'm done with whatever BS I'm spouting off on stage, I always get a hearty congratulations.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Nobody heard you.
I don't, you know, not for nothing. I don't mean to brag. You know, last year I didn't go, but the year before I went, I got a big bro hug from one of the big consultants in radio. One of the biggest consultants in radio gave me a big bro hug when I was done.
But they're not going to tell you you suck at something like that. If you had a horrible speech?
Yeah.
You don't think anybody, any one of them egomaniacs who was in radio down there at that big convention is going to tell you that you... They're all going to just pat you on the back and say how great you did, and you're going to keep going on thinking, yeah, I can do this again every year.
No, because I've seen the way people operate there. If you go up there and you eat a big bag of D's in front of everybody, they don't say anything. But if you go up there and you say something that might be somewhat intriguing or pointed or what have you, then they'll you might get a big bro hug from one of the big consultants of radio.
You got a bro hug.
I got a bro hug.
Are you? Do you give a speech every year at this thing?
I'm on a panel.
You're on a panel.
Usually it's a panel of
people.
And I bring it to the table.
And what time does your mom pick you up after you're done at playgroup? Right.
I don't need to.
What do you talk about? What are you going to talk about? Do you have a speech prepared?
It's not a speech. Well, there'll be a moderator. He'll ask questions.
What is it about?
Okay, I will tell you.
Yeah.
It is specifically about non-political talk radio.
Non-political talk radio.
Yes. I'm on this panel with a number of syndicated radio hosts.
Yeah.
A guy that used to be a consultant is now doing his own show.
Yeah.
A couple of doctors who do radio shows. And then there's me.
I don't know what the significance of us is to major markets like that, other big players in the world.
Steve, we all have our contributions to these things. And, this is like, how long I've been going there? 18 years?
Yeah, I know. But my point is anybody really listening to you?
Yes, it's a fully engaged audience.
I don't know.
In an auditorium who have paid... a good deal of cash to go to this thing.
This entire thing sounds like before they invented fun, because it's not.
Well, Steve, listen, it's just a part of what I do, because I'm really, without the bragging, I'm kind of a big deal.
I'm really glad I'm not into this as much as you are.
Well, a good part of it, to be honest with you, after going there for so many years, it's kind of like a reunion of pals all getting together.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's the same people. You're all like rubbing each other and, telling each other how handsome and great you are and how great you sound.
Is it wrong?
Yes, it's wrong.
I don't think it's wrong.
It's kind of nerdy.
There are some unsightly people there, I'll be honest. But, for the rest of us.
You're like the extreme of a political party. You're really into this radio thing so much that you're going to go hang out with a bunch of other radio nerds, some of which are much more successful than you are.
Well, I think it's all a matter of perspective, Steve.
You think so?
Yes. It is all a matter of perspective.
Sign me up for next year.
It's 731 with Bax and Nagle at Rock 102.
Here's Civic Sport for just $259 a month, or a 24 Accord EX for just $279 a month, or a 24 CRV EX for just $299 a month. So save a lot at Leah Honda, 20 Paloma Drive, Enfield, or leahhondaofenfield.com. Leah!
7:34 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102. It's time for news. Here's local radio icon Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax. Donald Trump became the first former American president to be convicted of felony crimes Thursday as a New York jury found him guilty on all 34 charges in a scheme to illegally influence the 2016 election through a hush money payment to a porn actor who said the two had sex. Trump sat stone-faced while the verdict was read as cheering from the street below could be heard in the hallway on the courthouse's 15th floor, where the decision was revealed after more than 9 hours of deliberation. This was a rigged, disgraceful trial, an angry Trump told reporters after leaving the courtroom. The real verdict is going to be on November 5th by the people. They know what happened, and everyone knows what happened here. Judge Juan M. Merchan set sentencing for July 11th, just days before the Republican National Convention in Milwaukee, where GOP leaders, who remained resolute in their support in the aftermath of the verdict, are expected to formally make him their nominee. The verdict is a stunning legal reckoning for Trump and exposes him to potential prison time in the city where his manipulations of the tabloid press helped catapult him from a real estate tycoon to reality television star and ultimately the president. Mm. As he seeks to reclaim the White House in this year's election, the judgment presents voters with yet another test of the willingness to accept Trump's boundary-breaking behavior.
Yet, oddly enough, in spite of all this, he and Joe Biden are practically tied.
Oh.
So, I mean,
I don't think anything is going to change anybody's mind.
I don't think so. You're either going to support the guy you believe in,
well,
or you're not.
If you're for him, it just reinforces your argument of how the system is rigged. And if you're against him, it reinforces your argument that he's not good for the country.
So I guess
I don't think that really changes anything. That's been that way for quite a few years now.
And so I guess it's really up to each and every one of us to decide, is this what we want?
You know what? I don't I worry about what's going to happen tomorrow in my own town.
I'm more
my own circle.
Right now, the things I'm focusing on in this whole thing.
Yeah.
Is how many games are going to take the Celtics to beat Dallas, and who's going to win the French Open? You know, right now, those are my two focuses, and you can take that for whatever it's worth.
Yeah.
Say I'm ignorant. Say I'm disengaged. Those right now, winning the 18th championship for the Boston Celtics is numero uno.
Well, there you go.
That's it.
State police have arrested a man in Lowell in connection to a violent robbery at a jewelry store in Holyoke. 20-year-old Henry Garcia was arrested Tuesday in Lowell on a warrant at a Holyoke, state police report. He's facing numerous charges related to a robbery at Shurin Jewelry in Holyoke on March 2nd, including kidnapping, masked armed robbery, assault and battery with a dangerous weapon, and felony larceny. But other than that, he's a great guy.
You got to go all the way to Holyoke from Lowell?
Well, he got arrested in Lowell. Doesn't he?
I know, but I mean, there's other... Yeah, there's other jewelry stores between, you know, here and 495.
Quite a few
of them, in fact.
Holyoke police officers were first notified about maybe he was going on a spree. A shopping spree.
Perhaps.
First notified about the violent robbery when the call came in just before 9 p.m. on March 2nd regarding a burglary alarm at the jewelry store. When officers arrived, the owner of the store told police he had been robbed, ultimately of thousands of dollars. It was later determined approximately $90,000 in jewelry was stolen by the suspect, later identified as Henry Garcia. Holyoke Police Captain Isaias Cruz told Western Mass News, but that wasn't the only thing that happened. The display case was shattered with glass everywhere as well as blood. The victim put up a fight and sustained injuries to his head from the suspect. We're told the suspect, Garcia, allegedly attempted to tie the owner up. The suspect attempted to tie him up in the bathroom. He fought his way out of it, explained Cruz. Police report they found a broken handgun at the scene, and from that were able to lift and match a fingerprint to Garcia, who was masked during the violent robbery. On Tuesday, Mass State Police Violent Fugitive Apprehension Section, North, and the Lowell Warrant Squad were sent to an address in Lowell on Market Street to try to locate Garcia. This was on a warrant that Garcia had been issued out of Holyoke District Court. So they got him. They took him into custody, and they found an AR-15 rifle with a sawed-off shotgun that were located in his duffel bag, and some jewelry.
All right, I'm not in the jewelry industry, but if I were, and I saw a guy walk through the front door wearing a mask, and I said, "Hello, sir, may I help you?" And he said, "No, just browsing." Do you think I keep an eye on that guy the entire time he's in the store?
I would hope so.
I would.
Yeah.
I would. That would be suspicious right off the bat.
I'm just looking.
Right. Yeah. And then, you know, then he's casing the place out for, well, what can I steal that's worth at least $90,000? So I can take that back to Lowell.
All of this stuff. I'm going to take all of it. 90 grand.
Yeah, 90 grand worth of jewelry and a whole lot of jewelry.
In Ludlow, an error in a parking notice led to panic. Next month, Ludlow will commemorate its 250th anniversary with a parade and block party taking place at Veterans War Memorial Park. Chestnut Street is one of the roads nearby with multiple housing complexes. Residents received a notice from the town's housing authority sent into the Western Mass newsroom by a concerned viewer, reading in part, Chestnut Street in its entirety will be closed from Friday, June 14th at 8 a.m. until Sunday, June 16th at 8 a.m. This is per the fire department, police department, and sheriff's department for the safety of the Ludlow 250th celebration. Safety is exactly what the viewer is worried about. To learn more about the situation, they stopped by the Ludlow Safety Complex. Police Chief Daniel Velada said the notice has a typo, as parking and road closures will only impact the neighborhood on Saturday, June 15th, the day of the event.
Oh, boy.
This is why you got to proofread, man.
You do.
Yeah.
Can't just let something go out. You can't just hit send.
You're looking at a 14-hour operational period for the 250th celebration block party, he explained. As for emergency response, crews will definitely be able to get through and respond if needed. Fire Chief Ryan Pease noted they plan for events like this frequently, like the annual Festa. Oh, you love that Festa.
I do. There's nothing not to love about Festa.
Executive Director Robin Carvide said in part, Ludlow Housing Authority is not involved in the planning or execution of the celebration. I was informed of the street closings from a celebration committee member and asked to notify the tenants of this so they can be prepared. It's all a big misunderstanding.
Well, where is that misunderstanding coming? Your inability to edit your emails and other publications.
Well, I don't think they really care too much about that.
Yeah, they should. Everyone's confused. No one knows where to go. No one knows where to park.
No one knows where to park. Where do I park in Ludlow? There is no place to park in Ludlow. You know what you do when you get to Ludlow?
What?
Turn around and go right back where you came from. Because there ain't nothing to see in Ludlow.
There's plenty to see. Ludlow's a nice town.
It's a town.
It's a town, but there's some very nice areas. And I tell you what, I spent a lot of time in Ludlow.
Really?
Well, yes. I go to Evan's Egg House on a regular basis. Two, I buy all my appliances at Kluwitz in Center Street in Ludlow. I believe my insurance agent's office is in Ludlow.
Who's your insurance agent?
I'd rather not say. And then Festa. What more is there?
I guess you're right, Bax.
You know, I'm looking for a good Portuguese meal. Let's say I'm looking for a big platter of pork and clams. I go to Ludlow.
Who doesn't love pork and clams?
Oh, it's so good.
Mixed together on a plate.
It's delicious.
And goat meat. Who doesn't like goat meat?
I happen to like goat meat.
I'm sure you do. It's the term ghost poop is trending on TikTok.
Why?
It's been on the Urban Dictionary for a decade, so it's not a brand new term, but most people have never heard of it. So what does it mean? It has nothing to do with the supernatural or spirits haunting your house and leaving something behind in the bathroom. It's one of two things, or sometimes both. It's when you use the bathroom, then look in the bowl and there's nothing there because it's sunk to the bottom and vanished.
Mm-hmm.
And, or, it's when you know you produced a solid product, but magically there's nothing on the paper when you go to clean up.
What the hell are we talking about
here? I have no idea. I was channeling our former co-host who was obsessed with stories like this.
What's your best poop story?
What's your best poop story, huh?
You know, I got a buddy.
I got a buddy who's into that kind of thing. People online think it's funny, but also wanted to know the health implications of a stinker that sinks so fast. And the good news, a ghost poo probably isn't something you need to worry about. They went through all of that.
Yeah, well, I mean, they do have a tendency sometimes to disappear on you.
What is this what we've become as a society?
In the same newscast, we've talked about a former ex-president being an accused felon.
Yeah.
And now poop that magically disappears.
Well,
interesting. What a straight line parallel that is.
Well, you know, this is what we do here.
Thank goodness.
But I'm just talking about the society in general.
Mm.
You know, when I was a kid and we talked about the future and, you know, watching the Jetsons or watching any of those like time travel movies,
mm-hmm.
think we'd have like real flying cars by now. We'd have, I don't know, what other kind of...
the common cold. We colonize the moon, that kind of thing.
Cancer would be cured.
Oh, yeah.
All the AIDS is gone from the face of the planet. But no, we have a trend on a video platform of where your poo goes.
There are a lot of mysteries in life, Steve.
Yeah.
This is among one of them.
Thank you, humanity. You have graced us with your presence.
It's like the David Copperfield of bathrooms, your information.
We're finally having the discussion we should have all been having for years.
I agree.
What is a ghost poo?
Ghost poo!
Your Pioneer Valley forecast today. It is going to be a really nice day. Sunny and a high of 77. Tomorrow, sunny and a high of 84. It's 45 right now in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on Rock 102. Oh, yeah.
Soak up the summer.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock at 7:52 in Journey with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Going to be a really nice day today. Sunny and a high of 77. Tomorrow, sunny and a high of 84. It is 50 right now in downtown Springfield.
Hard to believe it's the end of May, but tomorrow is June 1st, and Steve Nagle is going to be throwing a big party to celebrate the start of summer. And you're invited Saturday, June 22nd at Vanish Valley Brewing in Ludlow to celebrate the start of summer and to help raise money for Rick's Place, which provides free support for grieving children, teens, and their families after the loss of a loved one, and we want to help them continue the work that they do. Live music from John O'Neill, family-friendly activities, prizes for grabs, and food and beverages from Vanish Valley. You can get your tickets today at rock102.com for just $10.21. Every penny is going to go directly to Rick's Place. It's Steve Nagle's summer kickoff party, June 22nd, noon to 3, at Vanish Valley in Ludlow. See, another thing to do in Ludlow. And someone just said, what about Randall's? Another thing to do in Ludlow.
Yeah.
There's loads of stuff
in
Ludlow.
Yeah, there's loads of stuff to do.
You're going to have your badmouth Ludlow.
You can also go to jail over there, too.
Well, Steve, you don't have to be in Ludlow to go to Ludlow's jail.
It's kind of laughable because we never really crap on Ludlow.
I don't want to crap on Ludlow.
No,
I like
but
Ludlow.
I'm just doing this. Yeah, whatever good that town has ever done, huh? What's the best thing to come out of Ludlow?
The Mass Pike.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. One way in, one way out. There you go.
We have Open Line Friday coming up in a little while. Now, as you know, Open Line Friday always comes with inherent risk because we don't know what's going to come out of your mouth. But if we establish some rules early on, then we can maybe get through this unscathed. No vile language, no hate speech. Keep your stupid opinions reasonable, please. That way we can get through this with a lot of laughs.
I don't think we could do that, get through things reasonably.
Not with that bit.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
You know, Walmart, Target, and other retailers have been dropping prices to bring in more people.
Sure.
Maybe they should try this because it obviously works. A grocery store in Russia just got some very bad press this month after 18 customers landed in the hospital with food poisoning linked to their products. So to keep people coming in, the owner announced that if anyone got food poisoning, he'd pay them ₹1 million each, or about $11,000. The strategy worked, and people came back in droves, but for some weird reason, they were trying to get food poisoning. One report said customers were even licking the eggs, hoping they were covered in salmonella.
Yeah.
That's actually like a Willy Wonka golden ticket. Which one of these products in here has salmonella? Now run, Charlie, run to the bathroom, and don't stop until you run out of toilet paper.
You get nothing!
Yeah, you stole salmonella drinks. And one report, they were licking the eggs. And now the owner has canceled the entire thing. He says he'll pay the original 18 people, but only if they prove his products are to blame.
See, that's the thing. You kind of have to prove that you got it from whatever you bought there. And you can't just lick eggs in a store. That's gross.
Yeah, unfortunately, the place is next to an Applebee's. So people are going in there and then coming over to the grocery store. And the guy's like, hey, there's no way to tell where you got that salmonella from.
Yeah, I think you got to get patted down for an Applebee's receipt or something.
Yeah. Let me see what you do. I smell cheeseburger egg rolls on your breath. Which
you're cheeseburger egg roll smelling dogs.
Which also smells like the aftermath of a salmonella poisoning. Yeah. See?
It's about 7:57 at Rock 102.
GG Inks, screen printing and embroidery. They print their shirt on your back. Heck, they make the Rock 102 shirts that we wear and give out to you at events. Find them online at gginks.com.
gginks.com.
Leah Nissan has given you all the reasons to get into your new ride this month, like 0% financing and $2,000 off MSRP and all remaining 2023 Rogues in stock. Do not overpay with Leah Nissan. And exclusive to Leah Nissan, you get 3 years of no-charge maintenance. Stop in and ask for manager Miguel Aponte to get the Nissan you want at the price you need. Leah Nissan, Palumbo Drive in Enfield, $2,000 off MSRP and 2023 Rogues in stock, 0% up to 36 months, must be credit qualified, only valid in select models. See dealer for full details. Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 8:09 and Led Zeppelin with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
It's going to be a nice day today. Sunny and a high of 77. Tomorrow, sunny and a high of 84. It's 50 right now in downtown Springfield.
And now, live from the Richard Grieco Studios in East Long Meadow, Massachusetts, it's Open Line Friday!
All right, 293-1021. That is the number for the Route 10 Tire listener line.
Yeah.
Let's establish a couple guidelines so that we don't cause problems. I don't want to hear any filthy language. I don't want to hear any hate speech. And my God, please try not to be a dink.
Don't be a dink.
Don't be a dink. If we can be dink-free in this whole thing, then it will be a very successful open line. You ready to start taking them?
Let's do it.
Okay. Rock 102.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Rock 102. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, it's Joe from Brimfield.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
Hey, so how'd you all enjoy your Memorial Day?
Pretty good.
Yeah, it's a great day off as we memorialized everything.
Yeah, me too. I cooked up some burgers and hot dogs and all that. And let me tell you, if there's one good burger sauce, in my opinion, it's Mark Wahlberg's sauce.
Mark Wahlberg's sauce?
The Wahlberg sauce? You like the Wahlberg sauce?
Yeah, the Wahlberg sauce. Yeah, they're at Stop and Shop. And let me tell you, it is really good.
All right.
So what separates his special sauce from, say, somebody else's special sauce?
Oh, there's a lot of them. Like, there's like Chick-fil-A sauce, yeah, ketchup, mustard, Welsh, all that. Yeah.
All right. Well, good. Thank you for letting us know.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Appreciate it. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Good morning. This is Tony Rock calling. You're the top 40 disc jockey. How are you?
Good. What's up, Tony Rock?
Yeah. Well, be serious, Tony. Be serious. Well, I wanted to say a shout-out to my brother Andrew, my sister Laura, my brother-in-law Vinny, my little nephew Nicholas, and the people at the East Long Meadow Library. Hello, Kate. How are you, Kate?
All right.
And all right. Also, well, that's awesome. Is there anybody else?
The Hamden Library as well.
Ah.
Oh, well, there
yes.
you go. Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, you enjoy yourself a good weekend, okay?
Yeah, you too.
All right, thanks.
Very good. What was that whole thing about no dinks?
well, what? You can't prevent everything.
I understand.
Yeah.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey guys, it's John. How are you?
Good, John. What's up?
Hey Steve, I got a question for you. If I wanted to kind of dip into the world of DJing, where would I go? What's a good place to go to just kind of get some, I guess, beginner equipment and almost like a tutorial on how to use it?
A beginner? I'll go to ATC Audio down in West Springfield. They get a lot of experts down there, and they got some pretty good prices on equipment down there.
ATC Audio, okay. So
yeah, it's over by Pierways.
Kind of just, okay, awesome. All right, and I appreciate it.
All right.
There you go.
Happy cha-cha sliding.
Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, Backstastic and the Naglinator.
Right.
What?
Oh, that was
it. That's all you wanted to do?
I kind of like that.
Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, good morning. This is Cody.
What's up, Cody?
Hey, I just want to give a shout-out to my buddy Shaq and his boys who hate listening to you two.
They hate listening to us?
Yeah, no, you too.
Oh,
like
you
the
too.
Band.
The
oh,
band.
Okay, the oh, band. Yeah. I see. They're not a big.
Hey, I got a quick joke for you.
What?
What's the best way to carve wood?
I don't know. What's the best way to carve wood?
Whittle by whittle.
Ah, there you go.
All right, good one. All right, you have a good weekend there. Right there, there you go.
What's with the shout outs?
I don't know. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, this is John.
Hey, John. What's up?
I'm just curious where I can get a copy of that mixtape you guys played. You know, the Tom Van Jovi Smith. You guys put it on every day.
The what?
The what? What thing?
Tom Van Jovi Smith. You know, Tom Petty, Van Halen.
Yeah.
You get it. Yeah, where can I get a copy of
this? Well, you take your old boombox and you put a Memorex tape in there and you let it record all day long until the tape runs out, and then you got yourself whatever you call it.
Tom Van Jovi.
Tom Van Jovi.
I see what you're trying to do.
All right.
It is. I was curious where I'd get that.
All right.
That's what we do.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, this is Lieutenant Dan. How are you?
Lieutenant Dan.
Hey, just a quick gripe, really. Why do you guys do the weather like 1,000 times an hour?
Because we're told to do the weather 1,000 times an hour, and we're wrong about it most of the time.
I'll tell you why, Sergeant Dan. Most people aren't listening to the entire show, so if they check in, they don't hear the weather. Like, what am I supposed to do? Look outside a window?
Yeah.
That's an inadequate way of looking at the weather.
Listen, it's like one of those things. What do you do for a living?
Drive a tractor trailer.
You drive a tractor trailer. Do you have a supervisor, a boss, or your own boss?
I'm my own boss.
All right. Well, this isn't really going to work for you. But I'm just telling you that if you work for somebody else and they're in control of all of the things that, work that to provide you with pay at the end of a certain time period, you will do whatever is necessary for them to leave you alone for the most part. And if they want us to do the weather every time we come out of the break, then so be it.
That's it.
I'm tracking you, brother. I got you loud and clear.
All right. Thank you very much.
Yeah, by the way, it's 50 degrees in downtown Springfield.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, guys. It's Shaq.
Hey, Shaq. What's up?
Usual. Love Fridays. Calling in. Shout out to all the boys. Vince the Plumber. Cody.
Yeah.
the guy who just called. He's out in line. Hey, listen, you guys, I'm going to play this out for a couple more weeks because it's fun, but we're going to let you in on a little secret.
All right.
We know you guys are crying for to fill airtime, so we're going to help you out. I'll let you in on it in a week or two.
What, is some surprise that you have for us?
Nagle, I think you'll find it very funny and, interesting. Like, what? You guys, what?
All right.
Okay.
Well, these plumbers are up to something.
I know. Yeah. Some sort of they're in cahoots.
Yeah.
Rock 102. Good morning. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Yeah.
Shut that kid off.
Mike Jones.
Oh.
Oh, there you go.
Oh. Which one's the child?
Somebody gets the kid more mature than Mike Jones.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, this is Freddie over Central Square Grill. I just called him because Steve was saying nothing about Lolo. So I just wanted to tell you guys the news. Barburritos coming, Tom or Lolo.
Barburritos, you said?
Yeah, Barburritos, a new Mexican restaurant coming in to Lolo.
Oh, well, where? Where is that?
So there's going to be in 319 East Street, Lolo, where the Matt Wynn used to be there.
Oh, okay. Well,
now, from an Irish fella like yourself, how is the Latin food over there?
What's that?
Nothing. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, that's good to know. Appreciate the call.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
This is Mike.
Hey, Mike, what's up?
Hey, love your guys' show.
Mm-hmm.
Just wanted to say that Green Day is not classic rock. Please stop playing it.
Yeah, they're not punk rock either, but they're trying to put their hang their hat on that one too.
Yes.
All right. Well,
all right. Hope you had the time of your life.
Okay.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, this is Kevin.
What's up, Kevin?
Hey, just wanted to put in a plug for the Valley Blue Sox. They're still looking for a few host families, and just wanted to let everybody know that if they have a spare room and a kitchen they could use, they're in need of some more host families for players coming this summer.
All right, so how do you get in contact with somebody over there?
You can reach out to Brandon or Matt over at the Valley Blue Sox.
All right.
I don't have their emails at the moment, but I'm sure if you just look up their website or find them on Instagram, they'll have all the information posted on there.
All Very right. good.
That sounds good.
Appreciate the call. All right. Rock 102.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hi, Joe.
What's up, Joe?
Am I on the air?
Yeah, turn your radio down, Joe.
Okay, cool.
Now you can hear us.
I just wanted to say I've been listening to you guys for years. I'm down here in Connecticut.
Yeah.
And you guys just make me cry. It's so funny.
Oh. You know what? Are you listening to the same show? I haven't heard anything that would make anybody cry in pain is what I've seen something happen in the last 10 minutes here.
Cry and laughter with Hollywood trash.
Oh, yeah.
I friggin' die.
I know some people that are crying that we don't have Now Hear This anymore or
the Mass Hat.
The Mass Hat, yeah.
Which, who's never from Massachusetts.
I'll tell you, anything you guys do, seriously, you just make me laugh all friggin' day.
All right. Well, we appreciate you listening.
Thank you.
All right. Have a good day.
You too. Rock 102, good morning. Is this?
Yeah, a lot of plates.
All right. That's okay, Mike Jones.
That's Mike Jones again. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hi, it's Gary.
Hey, Gary, what's up?
I'm wondering, what's it going to take for me to get one of those buttons installed?
What button?
You know, the button you guys use to cut people off, like if they use appropriate language.
Yeah, no,
I would like one of those buttons.
Yeah, we don't really have those. We don't have those to give away. That's something you're going to have to build yourself.
Oh, because you're a better man than I, because the minute somebody said shout, I would hit that button, because shout-outs are so passe, like, it's kind of nauseating.
All right.
All right.
Save your stupid shout-outs.
What a shout-out. Dude, we're all about shout-outs.
Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, good morning. It's Ed down here in Hilton Head. I was just wondering if you guys had any more shout-outs left.
Yes. Go ahead. We only got three left. What's going on?
That's it.
All right. I just wanted to make sure we had some left. All right. I get you.
Yeah. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, it's Mike Jones.
Okay. Yeah. Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, how you doing, guys? I want to talk to all the Trump robots out there groveling in their seedy breakfast today. Screw all your robots. Trump is scum. Trump has lost. May you have a shitty weekend.
All right. Well, there you go. You ruined it.
You had to go down that road, didn't you?
You had your little political soapbox, and then you ruined it.
You broke the rules. All right. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Good morning. This is Bethany calling from Windsor Locks. How are you?
Hello, Bethany from Windsor Locks. How are you?
Hey.
What's up, Bethany?
I got a joke and a shout-out. Shout-out to Sam. Shout out to Sam at Automaster in Enfield.
Automaster in Enfield. Go ahead.
And what's
is
the joke clean, Bethany?
How does a crazy person get through the woods? They take the psychopath.
Oh, the psychopath. I get it.
All right. Bethany, she's a real
culture. You kept it clean and everything.
There
good
you go,
you.
Bethany. You can call. You can call back anytime, Bethany.
Good for you, Bethany.
Thank you. Have a great weekend. Have a great weekend, everybody.
You too.
You said you were going to make some new friends, and you did it, Bethany.
Well, other than that one little snafu.
Yeah, it sounds like everybody's taking a horse tranquilizer before they called in this morning. What is that? What is that all about?
What is it going to take to put you guys back in a position of excitement and thrills again?
These short weeks kill us.
They sure do.
Yeah.
Day 22 with Bax and Nagle at Rock 102.
The Rock 102
Golf. Deals. Shop today and discover great savings in every aisle. Stop and shop. Feed the moment.
Bax and Nagle.
And we hope you like it because they're under contract and we can't send them back.
On Rock 102.
It's 826 of Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
What's his name?
Don Maher.
Don Maher has the forecast for
you. All right. That's good to know. Let me see here. Oh, real quick. Backstreet's Musical Fun Bag this week. I'm going to have The Cure, The Damned, Elvis Costello, Devo, The Ramones. It's going to be a great show on Sunday night, 9 o'clock on Rock 102, all brought to you by Raspberry's Records, Windsor Street in Ludlow, and Shaker Road in East Long Meadow. Yesterday was their big grand opening. Stop by. Got taken care of. It was very, very cool. So thanks to them. Make sure you're listening on Sunday night for the other side of classic rock. It's Rock 102's Loudest Hour.
Loud Hour.
Yes, it is.
The Loud Hour.
Yes, it is.
We'll be back next week at the shortstop for the $20 dinner at a comedy show. We took a break last night due to a scheduling snafu.
These things happen.
But we'll be back in action next week. Can't beat dinner for $20 and a comedy show to go along with it.
All right.
I never heard, talked about it before, and I'm just hoping that everybody gets the
message.
Yeah,
it's kind of good to at least get it out there in the open so people might know that it's happening.
Absolutely. These cicadas.
Cicadas. Yeah.
I don't think I ever remember them being out anywhere I've ever lived.
Well, they come out, like, what is it, every 17 years or something like that?
Yeah. And this lady, she's, like, in one of these beekeeper suits. And I'm trying to see if I can find the where did I, what the hell did I just do with the audio? This lady, they're showing on the video that this, like, these landscapers are just covered in these bugs. It's gross, and they're huge. They're like these big giant thing, and of course they make a lot of noise too. I think that's a lot of the thing that other people get annoyed with. I thought that's all they did was make a lot of noise. These are crawling in neighborhoods all over people.
Oh yeah, no,
that's
gross. All bugs are kind of gross, really. But in particular, when these things come out and they're coming out in swarms, it's awful.
Yeah, that's just it doesn't seem to be a pleasurable thing to have these things hanging around.
Well, who's getting pleasure out of any swarm of bugs? Whether it's, flies, fleas, you name it.
Here's this woman in central Illinois resorted to mowing her lawn in a beekeeper suit. Here's what she has to say about all this.
We is under attack out here in Tennessee. We is out here fighting for our lives. Out here in Tennessee, baby. These cicadas have invaded. Like how they said them aliens was coming. It is time to rally the troops. See a cicada, shoot a cicada. I'm talking about see a cicada, stop a cicada.
She's pretty passionate about
that. Yeah, no kidding.
So there was a woman in Illinois resorted to mowing a lawn in a beekeeper suit. This woman, she's just sharing her opinions, but showing all the people covered in the cicadas.
Yeah, it's gross.
That's disgusting.
It is.
Those movies like The Birds or there was a whole like string of those movies.
Yeah, where like the animal
locusts.
Yeah, like the animals take over.
Yeah.
Like a plague of locusts would actually be pretty awful.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I mean, all the other plagues are pretty bad too, but that one, the plague of locusts, that's like one of the worst ones that that Moses put out there.
I like this lady. See a cicada, shoot a cicada. You know, and a buddy of mine, we were just talking about last night about the those guns. They're salt. You put rock salt.
Yeah.
They're called the bug assault, and you're supposed to be able to shoot them. I bet you could probably do some pretty good damage with one of those things.
You'd need a lot of salt for cicadas.
Well, I'm getting one.
It's 8:30. We got news next to Rock 102.
Here's your Western Mass News First Alert forecast.
After a chilly start this morning, going to be a beautiful day as we close out the work week. Lots of sunshine out there. Some fair weather clouds may mix in as we make our way through the afternoon. A little bit of a breeze. Northwesterly winds at around 5 to 15 miles per hour, but a seasonable afternoon as daytime highs will top out in the lower to middle 70s. Tonight, we'll see partly cloudy skies. Another cool night as we see overnight lows dropping back into the mid to upper 40s. Saturday, another beautiful day out there. A lot of sunshine. It's going to be a little bit warmer as well, with daytime highs in the upper 70s and lower 80s. We'll see more clouds mix in on Sunday. Very slight chance for a spot shower in the afternoon, but a lot of us are dry. Daytime highs, upper 70s to around 80. With your Western Mass News First Alert forecast, I'm meteorologist Don Maher.
Leah Honda of Enfield, where they're all about getting you on the road without breaking the bank. General Manager Aaron Boccaselli will get you in a 24 Civic Sport lease for just $259 a month, or a 24 Accord EX lease for just $279 a month, or a 24 CRV EX available to lease for just $299 a month. So whether you live in Summers or Wilbraham, Windsor, or even West Springfield, Agawam, or East Longmeadow, repeat after me. I am going to save a lot at Leah Honda. 20 Palumba Drive in Enfield or leahhondaofenfield.com.
Sunday, a Delaney House Sunday signature brunch day.
8:33 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102. It's time for news. Here's local radio icon Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax.
You're welcome, Steve.
For some reason, all these tabs just closed down on me. Because I opened up another internet browser by accident.
Yeah,
my bad.
It happened.
Donald Trump became the first former president to be convicted of felony crimes Thursday as a New York jury found him guilty of falsifying business records in a scheme to illegally influence the 2016 election through hush money payments to a porn actor who said the two had sex. The verdict is a stunning legal reckoning for Trump and exposes him to potential prison time in the city where his manipulations of the tabloid press helped catapult him from a real estate tycoon to a reality television star and ultimately president. As he seeks a return to the White House in this year's election, the judgment presents voters with another test of their willingness to accept Trump's boundary-breaking behavior. I don't think it's really a test. I think if you felt one way before the whole verdict, you probably feel the same way, and it just reinforces whatever your belief is.
Ultimately speaking, though, it doesn't prevent him from running for president. It doesn't prevent him from serving as president. All it really does is
make people more angry.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, that's what's mostly going to be accomplished here. He may not even serve any time in jail because he's got an appeal, and then he just might not serve jail time.
I don't think he will.
I don't think he will either.
I don't think, and again, you know, going back to our discussion about this at 6:30, rich people don't go to jail unless they steal from other rich people. Bernie Madoff.
He stole from rich people.
That other guy with the, what was his name? The one that just recently went to jail because he's the Bitcoin stuff or the
currents,
crypto, whatever.
I'm blanking on the name, but I know who you're talking about.
That guy.
Yeah, you don't really go to jail unless you make rich people less rich.
Right.
That's
when they throw the book at you.
Yeah, that's when you really serve the hard time.
Yeah. And really, it's not, I don't know.
People are going to vote the way they vote, and there are going to be some people that are just going to scratch their head going, I don't even know what to do.
Hey, Springfield just got a brand new Super Nintendo. Came out Thursday night.
It's a Superintendent.
What?
You said Super Nintendo.
Yeah, isn't that what that is?
No.
Like a new gaming system for the Springfield school system?
No.
You're going retro this year?
No, this is like a new boss of the Springfield schools. This is not a Super Nintendo.
Oh.
There's no Mario Kart. There's no there's no asteroids. There's no Space Invaders.
Then why am I bothering even reading this story?
Because it's an important story.
The search for the next Springfield School Super Nintendo came to an end Thursday night after weeks of controversy and a thorough interviewing process. Dr. Sonia Denal was selected over two other candidates. The three were asked how they would create a more diverse teaching staff.
And she's the only one who got it right.
Right. Yeah, she was the only one.
The only one who had the correct answer.
The other ones had phone a friend, and they didn't use that option.
Well,
and they should
have. They're going to need some remedial help, won't they?
The three were asked how they would create the more teaching staff. Dr. Denal was the previous chief of family and community engagement for the Springfield Public Schools. So there's a good positive sign. You're hiring from within. She says she's ready to make a difference within the school district. I'm determined to continue to use my career to level the playing field, champion equity, mitigate barriers to empower our students to achieve their greatest goals and the biggest dreams. Denal will lead the district of nearly 24,000 students in more than 60 schools. It's so weird to hear that number.
Yeah.
The 60 schools. I mean, I get the 24,000 thing because of the population of Springfield, but just the number 60.
Well, I mean, you think you've got different grade levels. And,
right, but off the top
multiple
of my
high schools.
Yeah, but off the top of my head, I can only name like five schools.
Well, you're not really vested in the Springfield educational system. You live in the Hilltowns.
Yeah, but even if I lived in Springfield, my kid went to Springfield, I still wouldn't know all of the schools in the system. You haven't studied. Well, maybe that's what these kids need.
Maybe if you studied, applied yourself, maybe you would be able to name all 60 schools in the district. And then I give you a big fat star on your forehead.
See, in New York City, you just got to know numbers. Public school 146, 147, 148.
I'm terrible with numbers. I probably show up to the wrong building every single day.
I've been noticing that. I don't even call you out on it, but I hear it back in the podcast. You say the wrong time at least twice a day.
I do not.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
I will prove it to you.
No, you don't.
Anybody out there who listens to our podcast, you go back and point out the times Bax has messed the time up when he says 7:53 when it's really 6:53.
You just said Super Nintendo of schools.
And that's exactly what we're getting.
A day after you talked about Debris on the road.
Who's going to be the Yoshi of the Super Nintendo of schools?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know who that's going to be.
More than 100 Enfield public school employees will lose their jobs as part of sweeping budget cuts that will also include all athletic programs for multiple grade levels. We talked about this yesterday. It's part of a plan approved by the Board of Education on Wednesday to cut $5 million from next year's budget. It's disheartening and it's frustrating, said Todd Kucher, a special ed teacher. People have been told they don't have jobs. They're crying, wondering if I'm next. Everybody is hanging on by a thread. About 130 positions will be eliminated. That list includes teachers, deans, behavioral techs, and central office positions. All middle school and ninth grade sports have also been cut. Enfield's mayor said that taxes have gone up 16% over the last 2 years and that taxpayers can't take any more. In response, the town gave the schools $3.9 million for the year and $1.5 million of the $6.5 million requested for next year. So we're already down in the deficit for next year.
That's a huge gutting, though. That's a lot of positions to lose.
That's a lot of positions, and I'm surprised more people aren't outraged about that.
You know, the problem is everybody wants new schools or good schools, but people don't always want to pay for it, and so those people aren't going to be outraged. But
no, but it would
but
be
you gut a school system like that, and you take away their athletic programs. That affects the quality of life of your town.
This is where an audit would be good for the town of Enfield to make sure that all the money that is being collected, if your taxes went up 16% over the last, what did he say, 2 years?
Two years.
16%, and you still don't have enough? There's something going on there about where the money's being spent.
Yeah, it's hard to tell. And, you know, can you say for sure that money is all going to the school department? Or is that just an easy place to cut
that's
funds?
That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
When towns do audits and things like that, this is where it would be necessary to do so.
Yeah, because, I mean, you wouldn't normally, cut 130 jobs because, City Hall got new carpeting. Heat-efficient windows, that'll really run you.
What was the one in Holyoke? They were getting an electric school bus. You know how much those things cost?
Just to plug in.
They're like $400,000.
For a bus?
For an electric school bus.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, but I'm saying when you talk about, we don't have funding for this, is the electric school bus the necessity versus the old diesel one?
I don't know, Steve, but can you really put a price tag on burning a hole through the ozone?
Yes, you can.
At $400,000 for a bus?
Well, and that whole thing, I don't even want to get into it. You're going to make me get political.
I don't want to make you get political.
I don't want to get political because I hate being political. And you talk about emissions and greenhouse gases and all that stuff. They're making us think like we're the schlubs that are responsible for all that.
I don't feel responsible. But me and my styrofoam cups are perfectly happy together.
You drive down the New Jersey Turnpike and you see all that smoke and acid going into the air.
Right.
But it's our fault for not driving a school bus with diesel fuel.
Yeah, maybe if you were recycling your plastics a little bit better, we wouldn't be having
these
issues.
It's not even that. That doesn't even work either. Most of that stuff winds up in the landfill. You can only recycle a finite number of items.
But don't you feel better knowing that you've cut your cardboard into your pieces and put them in your recycling bin?
No. I don't. What recycling bin?
You don't have a recycling. I got a big fat recycling bin in Hamden.
It's called single stream. You take everything, you put it all in one bag, and you throw it in the stream.
And here I was thinking that single stream meant something else.
Well, that's how you naturally dam up bodies of water. The beavers do it with the wood all the time. Why can't I do it with a Dasani and a Fireball bottle?
I don't
know. You have to utilize the tools that are given to you. If you don't,
you're a very resourceful man, Steve.
I'm very responsible. I'm very responsible. Look, if you can make tree forts out of this stuff.
And it will never biodegrade, which is the best part.
Yeah, and look, it'll look like it was sponsored by Coca-Cola or Budweiser or Fireball, of all things. Your Pioneer Valley forecast today, it is going to be mostly sunny with a high of 77. Tomorrow, sunny with a high of 84. It is 54 right now in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on Rock 102.
Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock. It's 850 and U2 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Your Pioneer Valley forecasts, sunny with a high of 77 today. Tomorrow, sunny with a high of 84. It's 57 right now in downtown Springfield.
Steve, it's a shop Friday this morning at 9 o'clock. If you go to rock102.com, you could save up to 30% to Cresella Butcheria. Cresella Butcheria. Ooh. I always get the Cresello right. I always get the butcheria part.
Butcheria.
It's an Italian-style butcher shop in East Hampton. The inspiration is a small family-run butcher shop in Rome. The meat is from local farmers and that they know and trust. You stop in for steaks, sausages, chops, or chicken, or just a sandwich. Cresella Butcheria in East Hampton. That starts at 9 o'clock today at the Shop 30 store on rock102.com. Don't miss out. 30% off. Pretty damn good deal.
That sounds like a cool place to go.
Absolutely.
Check that out.
I've heard nothing but wonderful things about it.
Well, there you go.
Let's see here. Next week, I told you that John Lodge from the Moody Blues will be our guest. Rock and Roll Hall of Famer John Lodge. He's got a brand new record out. He's going to be coming to Hartford and then also to the Webster Theater in Boston. And we'll give you all the details about that next week.
I'm going to ask him about Tuesday.
Afternoon. Yeah, no, I'll ask him about that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Will you?
Sure. Why not?
Are you saying you're going to ask him about it, or are you going to do it, or
We'll see how things go. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. I mean, it's next week.
Pretend you're the great Kreskin, okay? And you already know the answer to something. What do you think? Are you going to bring it up to him?
That we'd do that? No, I probably won't.
Okay.
Because I'm only given a limited time. I got a limited time with a guy, and we'll see what happens.
I was just checking. I knew you wouldn't do it. I knew you weren't going to ask him.
Well, I want to disrespect the guy.
How is that disrespecting? We're honoring the Moody Blues every time we say Tuesday afternoon.
I suppose. Yeah, I guess. Anyway.
This guy in Japan, a Japanese man who went viral for transforming into a dog, says he now wants to become another animal. Speaking to Japanese news outlet Wangkul.
Everybody Wangkul tonight.
Yes, Toko said it was a dream of his to transform into something else that works for his size, even if it's another type of dog. I would like to become another animal as well, he told the station, according to Yahoo Translation. I might realistically be able to become another dog, a panda or a bear. A fox or a cat would also be nice, but they're too small for humans to try. Mm. I'd like to fulfill my dream of becoming another animal someday. Toko spent around $14,000 on his hyper-realistic dog costume, which was completed last spring after trial and error with designs suited to fit his body on all fours.
Has he ever had any thoughts about becoming, say, like a pharmacist so he can give himself some antipsychotic medication?
No. He wants to be an animal, Bax. Don't let him.
I understand that. I just think that might be more helpful to him than trying to figure out what animal he wants to be this week.
He chose to model the suit after a collie since the larger breed works better for his size.
Right. Yes.
And the furriness would hide the human bone structure. Plus, that's good press to look like a lassie.
Yeah, but collies are very hairy. Dogs. They require a lot of grooming. They shed.
I don't know if he's doing any of that.
They get very hot in the summertime.
He's been documenting his journey into dog life on his YouTube channel, where he engages in canine activities like playing in the yard, rolling on the ground, eating dog food, and going for walks.
Or eating his own vomit and drinking from a toilet.
Toko once had a mixed breed dog of his own and said he felt the desire to become an animal very young, as soon as he was old enough to understand. He says he now wears his costume on his days off when he's not busy working.
As what? An animal control officer?
Well, he had an accident on the rug and then his mother rubbed his nose in it. Did you do that?
Bad dog.
Who did that? Who did that?
Now, when he rubs his belly, does his leg go kind of ballistic or what happens?
Yeah, he starts shaking. Doing all that. By the way, I fixed the trash problem in my house. The dog getting into the trash?
Yeah.
And it was as simple as a bungee cord.
Oh, so you have it around the top of the thing?
Yeah. So three for three this week, 3 days in a row, I've come home. The trash can has been knocked over.
Right.
But the contents have remained inside because of the super snap lid.
Yeah, see, that's when a dog finally starts to realize he's been outsmarted by a guy who has opposable thumbs.
You know, the funny thing is I will shame the dog.
Sure.
And not in like a mean way. I will just
say in a voice like this, if he were to get into the trash, who got into the trash? And I'm not kidding. He will like put his head down and then kind of like snarl a little bit like, it was me. I did it. I did that. Like, he knows. Like, the dog knows that he did something that he wasn't supposed to do.
You got a dog with a conscience, don't you?
I do.
Yeah. But yet it doesn't stop him.
Well, he's got urges, you know.
Well, we all have urges, but many of us are able to control at least some of them.
Yeah, but he's a dog. He's not going to be able to control. I'd rather have that than an over-sexualized dog that's humping everything.
Well, there's things you can do for that, too.
Well, yeah. I can't say the punchline for that one.
Thank you.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
Ah, man, but you want to hear the punchline to that one? Shortstop, every Thursday night, dinner at a comedy show. $20, we're back on June 6th.
That should be the first line out of your mouth on Thursday.
Yeah, about the dog?
Just the punchline.
Or just the punchline.
Yeah, not even the setup, just the punchline.
Okay.
And only a handful of people will get it, assuming they were listening at 8:56 in the morning on Friday.
So what do you do if a dog starts humping your leg? Find out the answer next week at the Shortstop Bar and Grill.
That'll work.
And that'll be the opening line.
It's 8:57 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Springfield's classic rock is everywhere. Rock102.com, the TuneIn app, and your smart speaker. Thanks to the Stream Team. Rock 102 and Hoole Construction. Hoole are the experts in hospital, private, medical, commercial, and industrial facility construction. RayHoole.com.
The Free Music Friday Concert Series is back tonight and all summer long at MGM Springfield. Tonight, from 7:30 to 9, you'll be able to enjoy live local music from some of the great bands in the area. This week, it's going to be the U2 tribute show, The Unforgettable Fire. But throughout the summer, you'll see Trailer Trash, Back in Black, Aquanet, Brass Attack, and many more. Plenty of refreshments and local food trucks on hand as well. And if you want to check out the complete lineup this summer, go to mgmspringfield.com. It's a Free Music Friday tonight and every Friday night all summer at the Plaza at MGM Springfield.